Trombone Choir concert. It's great to have all you people here with us today. Thank you so much for supporting live music and your fellow students and family and maybe just people who are here because they're curious. Really appreciate it. That first piece was Honor, the theme from the HBO from the Pacific, which is sort of like a cohort brother to Band of Brothers, which is a little bit more famous. But a pretty powerful arrangement there by Wesley Thompson, who is a Penn State grad. And we sort of have a relationship with Penn State. We've been down there as a group in years past, and I have a relationship with Professor Lust there. And so we play a lot of arrangements that come out of that school, and another great one. The next one that we're going to play, this trombone octet, is an original composition. It's sort of a classic, a staple in the trombone octet repertoire. This one by English composer Gordon Jacob. It's 8 parts. There's 27 or so of us, but we're going to double up and work it out. It's in 3 movements, and pretty much fast, slow, fast. So please enjoy Gordon Jacob's trombone octet.
Thank you.
fun to work on for the semester, and I think they did a good job. I'm really excited about working with this group for a lot of reasons. One is most of it is my studio, of course, that's the obvious thing. But it's also a club, and so there's a lot of people that you might see in here, probably half a dozen of them, that don't see me on a weekly basis. It might be a euphonium major or like an economics major. But in this case, we have a talented composer, Logan here, who was really excited at the beginning of the semester. He's a freshman, and he was like, "Professor Lombardo, do you think I could ever write something for the trombone choir?" And I was like, "Yeah, well, how about now?" And he was like, "Really?" And I was like, "Well, if you want to." And, you know, these young people are so amped about music that the next week he came in with his computer to his lesson and was like, "I have something if you want to see it." And he had already like a really solid sketch on a MIDI file of this idea for a trombone choir piece. And he was like, what do you think about it?" And I was really impressed, and I said, "Well, that's awesome. Do you think we could do it?" And he was like, "Wow, like next semester at a composer's forum?" I was like, "Well, how about on the fall concert?" And he's like, "Yeah, I think maybe I could probably get that done." And he did. And so I'm really excited to get to share his piece with you. And also, I should say that Philip's in the audience, and he's also a composer, though not a trombone player, at least not one that I'm affiliated with.
Not with you.
Okay, but clearly another trombone enthusiast, and the Honors Octet, which will be up next, is going to play a piece by another composer here at Fredonia, which I think is awesome to be for us to be supporting new music and supporting each other's talents and putting it to the forefront. So I would like to introduce Logan's piece now, and also I want to say that Jake has been a super help. Where did Jake? Where'd he go? Oh, Jake's gonna come out in a second. He's gonna conduct his piece, and he's fantastic. And him and the E board have been a big help running this show for the whole semester, and will continue for the whole year. They do all sorts of things, from sorting music to getting music out to dealing with getting money for guest artists, and anyway, a whole bunch of different things. And I count on all of them for a lot, and they really come through. So I'm excited to be able to give to Jake an opportunity here to conduct the choir on Logan's piece. So please enjoy.
Thank you.
performing professionally for 20 years. It's reinvigorating and inspiring to be around these young people that consistently find the magic in it every day. This kind of reminds me of why this all started, like why I got into this whole business to begin with. So it's really a pleasure to be here and be a part of this. This octet, I'd like to say, was the Honors Octet. I didn't mention that those are most of the principals in the different ensembles here, and they get together on their own and rehearse that. I mean, they're also busy with things, and it's not something that they have to do, but I asked them, I said, you know, we have this tradition, do you want to do it? And, you know, they all enthusiastically say yes, and they pick the piece, they get together, they rehearse it, they do the whole thing on top of everything. So, I think I want to commend their commitment to going above and beyond to do something like that. The next piece here, I don't know how many Star Wars fans we have out there, but if you've never heard of this show, The Mandalorian, you should watch it, I think. And if you don't like space movies, but you like westerns, then you should watch it. It's kind of like a western in outer space. And I actually was kind of late to the party with that. The first my experience with it was actually playing this theme at a BPO concert. It came on like one of the Star Wars, like one of these movie music things. And I played the theme. I was like, this is really good. This is awesome. And I should check this out, you know. So then my daughter, my 9-year-old, and I, we got into it, you know, and so much so that last Halloween, I had this Mandalorian outfit, and she was Grogu, it's kind of worked its way into our household, and so I was like, wow, I wonder if there's a trombone choir arrangement out there, and lo and behold, there is, and it was one of those products of the pandemic. You had a bunch of talented trombone players sitting around with nothing to do for a year and a half, and all these overdubs happened, and everybody was like, oh, I'm going to make this a piece and make that a piece. And so I found it, and it's a great arrangement, and it's a great tune, and yeah, it's a great series. So Mandalorian, Disney Plus.
Not sponsored.
Yeah, not sponsored. And for those of you non-brass players, you see some mutes. Like, you might, some of you not be aware of what's going on here with these different things in the bells, but since they come a bit, there's the straight mute, and there's the cup mute, which they're all playing, and then there's a Harmon mute later on in Buenos Aires, and they all have different colors, and they change the tone slightly. If you ever listen to the big bands of like Duke Ellington or Count Basie, you hear them all the time behind the likes of Frank Sinatra and Ella Fitzgerald. So here we go, Mandalorian.
Thank you.
So this next arrangement is a short snippet of the end of an hour and a half symphony by Gustav Mahler, the Second Symphony, the Resurrection Symphony. And if none of you have ever heard it before, I think it's one of those pieces that you gotta experience once in your life, whether it's on CD. There's some great videos out there. It's really impressive because it's like 150 people on stage. There's huge choruses, soloists, vocal soloists, like 100-piece orchestra. It's a mammoth work, and it's really one of my personal favorites. I was sort of obsessed with this one moment in the symphony. About three-quarters of the way through, there's this brass chorale. It's just the trombones, tuba, and contra bassoon. And it starts off as this really, much like this one does, this is later towards the end, but this is a beautiful chorale that grows into this enormous orchestration, loud brass and percussion, and it's really triumphant, kind of the story of dark, or light triumphing over dark, this whole symphony is, and so it's got lots of sublime moments like that. Particular spot we're going to start is right at the end when the chorale comes back again, but this time with the voices and the chorus and the whole orchestra. It's really powerful. I told the students, I said, if you just play what's on the page, they're going to think it sounds great. Mahler took care of everything else. It's just a perfect piece. I also mentioned our little tie to Penn State. We did this arrangement. It was new to me. But I was exposed to it when I took the crew down to Penn State for the 30th annual Trombone Pavane, which is this congregation's meeting of like the Eastman and Ithaca and Penn State Trombone Choir that they had been doing for many, many years. We went down there, we played this choreographed with I don't know, who was there? Anybody still there? Ian was here, right?
Just Mike.
Just Mike. So, but it was probably like 100 trombones or something. It's huge, so you can imagine the sound. But they do pretty good with 27, so here we go.
Thank you.
operational battle station. Okay. Probably should have just ended with that, but I always end with Buena Sera. It's our little calling card, clear tradition. So it ties all the generations of the trombone choir together. We all play this piece at the end of every concert. Thank you so much for coming. And thank you for supporting the young men and women on these stage. And enjoy the rest of your holiday season. Oh, if you're like totally jammed about this and you love it and you want more, there is one more. It's on December 10th, on Saturday, December 10th, we're going to play a holiday concert, totally different music, a pre-concert at my orchestra's home, the Buffalo Philharmonic, in Buffalo, at Mine Hands Music Hall. We're doing a pre-concert concert at 6:45 on December 10th. And then there's a concert for the orchestra, the BPO concert after that, so you get like a little twofer there, and two for the price of one, and it's really great. It's beautiful, the hall's all decked out in holiday spirit, and it sounds great in here, and we have great arrangements. So, hope you can join us there if you're into it.
Good night.